Tons of you guys have been asking about my microscope. You know, where did I buy it? What brand is it? Where can you buy one? How much did I pay? And today, I want to answer all of those questions. But first, I want to tell you guys a story. When I was a kid, I was obsessed with electronics. Well, and bonsai trees and needlepoint and chainmail armor. Let's face it, I was kind of a weird kid. But today I want to talk about the electronics. I was obsessed with taking things apart, with understanding how they worked, and building my own new things from them. I really wanted to make my own robot. I found this article in Boy's Life, which is sort of like the Boy Scout magazine that I got when I was a kid. It talked about building your own robot from a trash can and a motor taken from a toy truck. And for me, a trip to Radio Shack was pretty much my idea of heaven. And so for me, coming to the electronics markets here in Shenzhen, China, is literally a childhood dream come true. I think if I'd come here as a kid, I would have refused to leave. I would have just begged the nearest Chinese family to take me in, and I'd become one of those market kids that sits around doing homework amongst the big piles of cable here. In many ways, exploring Shenzhen and the manufacturing scene here over the past couple years has really been about fulfilling childhood dreams. One of the things I really struggled with as a kid was soldering. The solder would get all clumpy and I'd rip pads off the board with the tip of the soldering iron from pushing too hard and generally just make a mess of things. My expectations of myself far exceeded my abilities. It was extremely frustrating and I saw it as like this permanent irrecoverable failure. I mean, let's face it, I was a really clumsy kid. I had terrible hand-eye coordination. I regularly ran into door jams. I thought it was a lost cause. But much, much later, as an adult, I realized a lot of those deep-seated beliefs were actually false. I mean, I'm still a klutz. Like, I still run into door jams sometimes. But I realized that a lot of those personal failures actually could be kind of worked around with better equipment. As a kid, I had like a crappy Radio Shack soldering iron for a few dollars. It wasn't temperature adjustable and it was hard for me to keep the tip clean and tinned, but it was amazing. Like I had the power in my hands to melt metal and I only melted the carpet like once. Sorry, Mom. Well, and I only occasionally used it for other things like wood burning. Actually, Mom, you probably should just stop watching now. But in recent years, as an adult, I've discovered the joys of owning a proper soldering station. You know, one with interchangeable tips and temperature control. Right now, I'm rocking a kind of an entry-level Heiko station that a friend gave me, which has been awesome. But the real game changer, well, that was buying my microscope last year. It's really allowed me to do things I didn't know I was capable of, and in the process, it's really changed how I see myself. It all started with this, what seemed like an impossible task, to solder these little tiny wires onto the back of a lightning jack as part of my project to try and add the headphone jack back on an iPhone 7. If you haven't seen that, there's a video about that up here. You should definitely go watch it. But I really found that pretty much a non-starter just with my bare eyes. I wasn't having any luck. And using this $10 cheap USB microscope, it wasn't really any better. But under this bad boy, not only was it possible, but with a little bit of practice, it was actually pretty straightforward. Being able to see what I'm doing up close was a real game changer for me. Not only could I finally like really see what I was doing, but actually my hands got a lot steadier under the microscope. It turns out our brains are just incredibly adaptable. You know, with some practice, it becomes pretty easy to use like tweezers under the microscope, syringes, even soldering irons. Frankly, it feels like I've got a little bit of a superpower. Microscope boy leaps over capacitors in a single bound. All right, I might be getting a little bit carried away, but I did want to talk about the microscope. I bought it here in Shenzhen last year in the electronics markets called Huashangbei in a building called SEG, I bought it from a nice lady named Su Mei, that is a Chinese microscope seller. She's on the second floor of SEG. I went to a number of microscope booths before I ended up buying this one. But Su Mei was the first person that I talked to who really had what I needed. I needed a binocular microscope with a camera. And not just with a camera, but with a camera that works when the two eyepieces are working. And that's important for two reasons. So obviously, the camera is for you guys so that you can see what I'm doing. And the eyepieces, those are for me so that I can see what I'm doing. But in particular, I wanted optical eyepieces, right? I didn't want to be looking at a screen the whole time and just looking through the camera. That's because when you have a camera and a screen, you're introducing some latency into the loop. And that kind of destroys this really important feedback that's happening between what your hand is doing and what your eyes are seeing. If you can get the latency in that to be essentially zero through using an optical setup, that is way, way better than if you introduce latency with a camera and a screen where your hand starts to get disconnected from what your eyes are seeing and your brain gets all confused. Secondly, I wanted a binocular microscope where both eyepieces worked the whole time. And the reason that's important is for depth perception. So you want to be able to judge how close to the work you're getting. Like if I grab a pair of tweezers and I'm looking through the microscope here and I'm going to go grab a component, without that depth of field, I don't really have a sense of how far above the work my tweezers are. There are actually two lenses, one for each eye, and that's super important. We want to have that same sort of separation between the two eyes that our own eyes have, so that we have two slightly different pictures of what we're looking at. And that's what gives us that depth perception. The most important thing was to be able to have that binocular vision, both eyepieces, and the camera running at the same time. This camera is 1080p camera with just HDMI out, and then I run that into my computer with just a cheap like USB HDMI capture device. Comes with a ring light here for seeing your work. The last thing, which is really important, is this. And this is a Barlow reducer. It's a 0.5x reducer, so it allows you to raise the microscope twice as high. If I didn't have this, I'd have the microscope down here, and it wouldn't be enough room to really get in there with like soldering irons and hot air guns and tweezers and everything. So by adding that, that just screws on to the bottom of the lens here, and like this, and that allows me to have it up this high. Now, a lot of you guys have asked me, well, what brand is the microscope? And there's no brand anywhere on it. The best I can tell you is that I bought it from Su Mei in the markets on the second floor of the SEG building. But a lot of people have been asking me, like, where do I buy one? Can you get one for me? And I was thinking about it. I thought, oh, maybe I can go to Su Mei. She doesn't speak any English or doesn't speak much English. And she's not really set up to trade outside of China. So I thought, well, you know, maybe I can buy a bunch of microscopes from her, and then maybe I can put a Strange Parts logo on it and it can be the Strange Parts microscope, and then I'll sell them from the Strange Parts store. But I realized I don't actually want to do customer support for microscopes. I'm already busy enough as is making videos. So instead, I reached out to Su Mei and she set up an AliExpress store just for you guys. So she's giving you the same deal she gave me, which is one hell of a deal. It's $300 for everything. She's not paying me to say this. This is not a sponsored video. You guys keep asking me and she seems like a nice person. And so I wanted to help everybody out. If you want to buy a microscope from her, she would love it. $300 and then you have to pay shipping on top of that because these things are heavy. If you're struggling to do fine detail work, whether it's soldering or model making or needlepoint or calligraphy, I'd strongly suggest that you go out and consider getting a microscope. It doesn't have to be this one, but for me, this was a real game changer. And I think you might find that you also have a hidden superpower you didn't know you had. And lastly, if I could say one thing to my younger self, it would be this. Our taste develops much faster than our skills. And so if you're frustrated by your ability to create what you have in your head, if you feel like you're never gonna be able to make something that measures up to your expectations, be patient. It'll come, it'll take time and it'll take practice, but you'll get there. If you'd like to hear more about this idea, it's actually something that I got from Adam Savage on the Still Untitled podcast that's done by Tested. It's Adam Savage and Will and Norm from Tested. It's really kind of a beautiful conversation about this idea of our taste and our skills sort of developing at much different paces from each other. I'll put a link to that podcast in the description. Highly recommend going and watching it. As always, I'm Scotty from Strange Parts. If you enjoyed this video, hit that subscribe button down below. And if you'd like to be notified about future videos, hit the bell icon next to the subscribe button. If you guys would like to see this microscope in action on some of my projects, you could check out the video that I did about trying to add the headphone jack to back to the iPhone. That's here. And then I just did one about upgrading iPhone memory, so you can check that out here. I'm using the microscope again. That does it for today. I've got a bunch more exciting stuff on the way, so stay tuned. I'll see you guys next time.